in 1984, I was hit by a car, and I flew 40 feet in the air and landed on my neck and received a spinal cord injury. I was 24 when I entered the disability community. One day able-bodied, the next day living in a whole new world. And I realized that I was the same woman, but everyone started treating me different. There was really not a lot of support as far as empowerment, self-esteem building. So I had the vision of just starting a group with the women there to just help one another make it through the beginning of our life as a woman with a disability.
Well, individually, it's been a phenomenal impact. If someone is diagnosed with a new injury or sustaining a new injury or diagnosed with a new disease, it's so important to have someone there that has been through the experience for that kind of support. You feel so alone, you feel so lost, you have so many questions, especially about your own personality, sexuality, independence, and it's nothing better to have a woman there who's been through it.
And the unique thing about WEAN is when we say we understand what these ladies are going through, we really understand. Because this life is not easy, and we don't try to paint this rosy picture. It's not an easy life, but it's a life that we can accomplish.
That's wonderful.
And most of us have been able-bodied, and through different circumstances, we have disabilities.
So I didn't have any support at all, and I felt really like, you know, I wasn't worthy. I wasn't who I was, you know. And the WEAN ladies, as my son calls them, the WEAN women, they just wouldn't give up on me. And so after about a week, the WEAN women, they wore me down, just built me up again and made me feel whole.
So we paint a new face, not only for women with disabilities, but for the community disability as a whole.
We work with women who usually have brand new disabilities. They've had many different things happen to them. They've been in car accidents. They've been shot, some of our patients. They may have a spinal cord injury, like a paraplegia or quadriplegia. Some of our patients come to us with a traumatic brain injury, and suddenly and abruptly, in the blink of an eye, their life has changed. One of the things we do a lot of is inspire hope.
When I first meet people who are newly disabled, I encourage them to take the day 1 second at a time, or maybe a day at a time, maybe an hour at a time, because initially all that you can think of is what you've lost.
How the disability will play out, some days is good, some days is bad, and then some days it's just like, oh, who cares, you know? This is the way I am. But eventually you'll get to a place in your life where you will accept this disability. You'll realize that you are disabled, but you cannot let it hold you back.
But even if a person doesn't get a lot of recovery, they can still have a good life and can still be active and do many of the things that they did before.
He's still at the dock.
One woman comes to mind, and she was going through the stage of depression, anger, so she didn't welcome us in the beginning.
And Rhonda came in the room, and I was laying there looking all, I know, a mess, and all depressed feeling, right? And she wanted me to come out to this group. I was like, okay, whatever. Yeah, okay, I'll come, okay. And she was looking all gorgeous in this chair, and I'm like, I don't want to see her. She looks all pretty and everything. Then Sunday came. Here come Rhonda again. Oh, are you coming to the meeting? No, they haven't gotten me out of bed yet. I'm not dressed, so I'm not going to be able to come. Thinking that that would be, I could use that as an excuse, and no. She went out there in the hallway and got some nurses and the techs and everything. She rallied up everybody.
We knew that she needed us. So little by little, we would continue to go see her. And one day she was like, well, I see you guys are not going away. You know, and she started coming out to the meeting, and now she's a big part of who we are. So that's where we bridge the gap between rehab and the community, to let these women know that we're there. And WEAN has grown, and we're very community involved. So people know who we are, what we do, and our mission of empowering women.
One of the most significant events that we do every year is called Bags of Hope, where we collect toiletries throughout the year. And we put together like 200 bags, and we distribute them to women with disabilities during the holiday season at the rehab centers. And just leaving a gift with them, leaving a card and a phone number, is very touching for them, and I think it gives them a lot of hope, and that's why we call it Bags of Hope.
When I had one lady said, I never thought I would wear makeup again. Who would want to look at me? No man would ever find me attractive. And she said, once she saw us and we came in there and our nails were done, our makeup was on and our hair, she's like, wow, you know, I can be beautiful again.
We call ourselves the WEAN Queens. It's really sort of cute because we treat ourselves as such. And even once a year we have a queen for a day at the Women's Expo, which is just to treat young ladies who might not have. We serve them breakfast, we give them makeup makeovers, we serve them lunch. It's really, really nice.
And we're a sisterhood, and that plays such an important role.
I'm Kiana Mayo.
I'm Rhonda Ward.
My name is Valerie Smith.
I'm Rhonda Myers.
I'm Danielle Worthy.
And I have a spinal cord injury.
And I'm an amputee paraplegic.
And I have cerebral palsy.
And I have a spinal cord injury.
And I have a degenerative joint disease.
Hi, I'm Janice Jackson. I've been the director of WEAN for 6 years, and I have a spinal cord injury.